Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand.
Let's talk about using AppReader and the different modes that that we have under AppReader. So real quick, what is AppReader? Switch over to Word, control home to go to the top of the document. And let's just hear an example of AppReader.
Boroughs of New York City. Manhattan, New York County, is the geographically smallest and most densely populated.
All right. So AppReader is the tool that we can use. It's a couple tools that we can use to read information that's on the screen, okay? And it is located under the Reader tab on the ZoomText interface. Under the Reading Tools section, here we have AppReader. So under AppReader, we have these three tools we can choose from. And before we go more into that, just real quick, let's talk about what are the benefits of AppReader. So let's say I have a visual condition where I can read my emails, I can read Word documents or web pages with the assistance of ZoomText. I can read it fine, but let's say, you know, after lunch, my eyes start getting tired, or maybe I start getting headaches. AppReader is going to help me with, you know, if I have that condition, it's going to help me with eye fatigue. So it'll read that stuff on the screen for me rather than me having to rely on my eyes to do it. Another example would be maybe we use higher magnification level and it's harder to track words to read. It would be helpful in that case too. Overall, it's a really cool tool to have available. Under AppReader, again, we have the three tools, the three modes, I'm sorry, App View, Text View, and the Speak It tool. And then we have some settings we can access. We'll take a look at those too. So let's go back and take a look at App View. Before we do that, I'm going to be using some keystrokes. I'm going to hover over the AppReader button here. I always want to point this out. It's a cool feature in ZoomText. You can hover over these buttons on the ZoomText interface if you're curious to what the keystrokes are to launch them. So if, say you wanted to know what mouse echo, you can use caps alt M. If I hover over voice, caps lock enter. Always like to point that out. Another thing worth pointing out here, you'll notice that voice is disabled. We don't have voice enabled. I'll get the question sometimes that, you know, do I have to have voice enabled in order to use AppReader? The answer is no, you don't have to do that. So let's alt tab back over to Word, control home, go to the top of the document. And I'm gonna turn color enhancements on with caps lock C as in Charlie, just to make that a little easier on the eyes. So AppView is gonna read the text in the source application. So when I press the keystroke Alt caps A is in Alpha, he's just gonna start reading here in this Word the Word window. So let's do that. Let's press caps Alt A.
Boroughs of New York City. Manhattan, New York County, is the geographically smallest and most densely populated.
Okay, I'm going to hit the control key on the keyboard to pause or interrupt speech. I can also click the left mouse button. That will do the same thing. You can also press enter on the keyboard to pause. So let's take note of a few things here. So when I activated AppReader, we saw this red rectangle pop up around the word. It's highlighting the word that's being read. So as it reads along,
populated borough is home to Central Park and most of
that highlight highlights the word being read. The other thing we'll notice is that when AppView is active, we have a little icon that's attached to the pointer. It's a little square. It kind of looks like an application window that lets us know that AppView is active. So I paused it with the control key. I'm going to click the word Brooklyn. I can click around the screen. I can say I want to jump down to the Bronx. I can click the word the at the beginning of that sentence. And I can continue reading by pressing enter.
The Bronx County, is New York City's northernmost borough and the only New York City borough that lies mainly on the...
I'm going to hit control again to pause speech. And that is an example of AppView. Once I'm done reading, let's let it read to the end here.
Ellis.
I'm going to click Ellis. This is the last sentence on the document.
Ellis Island and Lower Manhattan. End of document.
So ZoomText told us this is the end of the document. And so to exit, I'm just going to press the escape key. You can also press the right mouse button. Hit escape. And there we go. So let's, I'm going to hit control home, just go back to the top of the document. I'm going to turn color enhancements off. I'm going to go to the desktop. Then I'm going to hit caps control U to bring the ZoomText interface back into the view. I'm going to click the app reader menu and I'm going to look at app view settings. So under app view settings, we have a couple options, track and highlight words. You can disable that. That's what caused that red rectangle or the red frame to follow the word that was being read. And then we can say, you know, do you want to exit app view at the end of the document? Basically, that automatically just closes app view when the document, when it reaches the end of the document. I'm going to leave those on. I'm going to change the highlight from a frame to an underline, and I want to make it a green underline. And we'll leave the thickness and transparency of that underline the same. So I'm going to hit OK. I'm going to Alt-Tab back to Word. I'll turn my color enhancements back on, and then I'm going to put my cursor at the beginning of the paragraph about Queens. And I'm going to press Alt-Caps, A is in Alpha again.
Queens, Queens County, on Long Island north and east of Brooklyn, is geographically...
There we go. This time I click the left mouse button to pause speech. And now we can see that we have the green underline instead of the red frame that's tracking or the highlighting the word. So that is app view. So let's take a look at the second reading mode, which is called text view. So I'm going to turn my color enhancements back off. So app view, what we saw, that reads in the source application, okay? So if I want to use text view, I'm going to hit Alt Caps T as in Tango.
Geographically, text, the largest borough, the most...
And we can hear that it automatically starts reading. So text view pulls this text into a different window, special environment that makes it easier to read. So if a user wants to read along, a text view may make it easier for them to do that. We can see that it's white text on a black background. It's in a prompter view. We have some buttons at the top that we can use to change the, we can change it to ticker view. So it's a like a ticker tape across the top of the page or the window. Right now it's in prompter view by default. We have the option to click app view, which would just launch, it would go back to the Word window and launch app view, which is like what we were just looking at. We can also, there's a play button, which is just like hitting enter to continue reading. We can increase zoom.
Zoom level 7.
Or decrease zoom.
Zoom level 6.
And then we can change the speech rate.
Rate 115.
If we want to speed up speech rate. So, and in this window, in the text view window, it's the same rules apply. I can press enter to begin reading.
Most definitely the first county in the United States.
I can press control to pause. I can click the left mouse button to pause. And then I can also just press escape when I'm done reading it. We also have a settings button up here. And we can choose our font, the font style, the document color. So what color text on what color background. You have some formatting options. And just like app view, we can change the highlight. So let's say I want to make it an underline. A green underline, just like I did with app view. I'm just going to say okay, and then I'll press
United
enter.
United States and the most ethnically diverse urban area in the world, historically a collection. United.
There you go. And so that is text view. And I'm going to press escape to exit out of that. So we're back in our Word document, and I want to look at the Speak It tool now. I'm going to turn color enhancements back on, caps lock C, using Charlie. Speak It tool. I'm going to press Alt caps S.
App reader, speak.
Sierra. And we heard ZoomText say app reader, speak it tool. And next to my mouse pointer is a little dialogue box. It's like a speech bubble. letting me know that the Speaker tool is active. So when Speaker tool is active, we can use it for things like spot reading. Say we just don't know what a certain word is, we can click it.
Burrows.
Or we're having a hard time making out what the word, what it is. We can just simply turn on Speaker tool, click the word.
City.
Another cool thing, and it's not doing anything. It's not moving the cursor to the word I'm clicking.
City.
It's simply just reading what's under the pointer as I click it.
County.
Another cool thing I like to use this tool for, Speaker tool, is to explore an application. So we're in Word. Let's say I was new to Word and I'm not sure what some of these icons in the ribbon were. For example, the center button. It's just a couple lines. Maybe let's say I'm not sure what that is. I can click it.
Center CTRL plus E.
And it doesn't activate the button. It just simply says center. And then it said CTRL plus E, control E. So that's it let me know the keystroke is control E. If I click the B for bold.
Bold CTRL plus B.
Bold CTRL or control plus B. And then say I'm having a hard time making out what the name of one of these tabs is on the ribbon, I can click it.
References. Mailings.
And I can do all this. And again, it's not activating anything. It's just simply reading what's under the pointer. So, excuse me. Find this tool can be quite helpful. And again, like the other two app reader modes, I'm just going to press escape to exit. So we've looked at using this in these app reader modes in Word. We can use it in Outlook. We can also use them in Chrome. I'm going to go over to Chrome, where I have a Freedom Scientific page open, what's new in ZoomText 2021. Let's say I wanted to scroll down. Let's say I want to have ZoomText read to me about the FS support tool. So I'm just going to get that text in my view, and I'm going to press Alt Caps A.
FS support tool for gathering system information. The FS support tool is a new utility that collects information about your computer and sends
a control to pause. And again, that's the app view tool. So it's just reading there directly in Chrome. If I wanted to read this in the text view, I could press Alt Caps T. And again, if I needed the Speak It tool to do some maybe spot reading or checking on what a certain word is or what a button is, I could do that too. So just an example of that again, I'm going to go to the top of the page here. If I mouse over these items, for example, if I put my pointer over downloads, it opens this menu. But if I turn on Speak It tool, Alt Caps S.
App Reader, Speak It tool.
And I put my pointer on it, nothing happens. If I click it,
downloads.
It tells me it says downloads. So those are the reading modes and under App Reader. So I hope you found this interesting. I hope everyone has a great day.
Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand. To stay up to date on upcoming webinars and training events, complete the sign-up form at freedomscientific.com/webinars. Thanks again for connecting with us.